Hi, I'm George at StudioBinder, and today I'm going to show you a really cool feature with templates that allow you to double your productivity and really customize your workflow. So let's check it out. So the first thing we're going to do here is we'll go up here to this, right on the upper left here, there's a button next to your production calendars, drop down, save as template. Then we'll click this, and we'll be prompted here to create a calendar template. I would go with the name that covers the kind of project you're doing. So for example, this was a short film. We might want to name this one Short Film Template. And now we have a template created out of this calendar. So I'll show you how you can actually use this feature. You'll go up here into your production calendars dropdown again. We'll click on it. We'll add a calendar. So we got a new short film in the pipeline called The Lost Guitar. And now when we select our templates, we can always do blank calendar. We have some templates provided to us, but here we go, short film. That's the one we just created. And also note how you have the option to remove templates. So if there's one sitting there for a while that you never use or you don't want anymore, all you have to do is go over up here to this X and delete it. But we're not gonna do that now. We're gonna select short film. We're gonna go to next. And now here's another set of options. We can modify start date. So let's just say we're shooting in April. Now you can include every event, which means every single thing you drew on there, like casting, rehearsals, etc., etc. You can include all your tasks, which means any subtask you created for an event will be along there too. You can include the people you worked with, which is really cool because say you got the exact same team, you don't need to take the time to put them in there, they're already there. On the other hand, if you're working with a whole new team, you don't need to bring anybody over. So let's just say we'll take teammates off. You can include your uploaded files. It's likely to be a different project with different scripts or sides or what have you. So you'll probably keep that one off. Include comments. If there were comments that you found super useful that you want to have with you on the new project, but typically you might not want this one because the comments would have been project specific. So we'll leave that one. And include task progress. Now this is one you're almost definitely going to leave off because it would import to the new calendar all the tasks that have been checked already, which could become very confusing if it's a new calendar and there are tasks that haven't been completed. So now that we've got all that covered, we're going to create our calendar. And here we go. Every single event exactly the way it was. And it's a great way to streamline your workflow, but also customize your process. So you can say, I always want these sets of tasks. I always want these events. And then I'll move it around from there. Hope you found this helpful today. As always, leave a comment below. Let us know what you think. And if you want to see more pro tip videos like this, come back for more. Thanks so much.